Good morning, my dear students. How are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today we will discuss the question and answers of chapter 13 of geography, a globe, latitudes and longitudes. So as we have completed the chapter, so we will discuss the question and answers. Okay, so take the correct answer. First question is, the earth's axis is, so the answer is an imaginary line on which the earth rotates. Now, second question is, the torrid zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, so third is, the total number of meridian is, it's 360. Yes, the equator is also known as the Great Circle. The longitude that determines the Indian Standard Time is 82° 32' east. Okay, now next, straight, true and false. All lines of longitudes are circles. Yes, all lines of longitudes are circles. No, false. All lines of longitudes are the semicircles. Zone. Okay, third number, geoid is the term used to describe the shape of the earth. Yes, it's true. The world is divided into 28 time zones. No, it is divided into 24 time zones, so that's why it will be false. The Antarctic Circle lies in the northern hemisphere. Yes, the Antarctic Circle lies in the northern hemisphere, so it's true. Now let's proceed to question number 3. What is a globe? The earth is represented by a spherical model, which we call it as globe. Okay, now next question is, name the heat zone in which the equator is located. The heat zone in which the equator is located. Okay, so the equator is located in the torrid zone. Question number 3. Name the latitudes between which is located the North Frigid Zone. Okay, so the latitudes between which the North Frigid Zone is located. So the North Frigid Zone is located between Arctic Circle and the North Pole. Next question, what is a grid? The network of lines formed by latitudes and longitudes on a globe or a map is called a grid. How is the local time in India known as? The local time in India is known as Indian Standard Time or IST. Okay, it is a Indian Standard Time. Now, question number 4. Number 1, define latitudes and longitudes. So, latitude is an angular distance of a place north or south of equator, and longitudes, it is the angular distance of a place on the surface of the earth measured in degrees east or west of prime meridian. Number 2, why it is always called cold at the poles? So poles are always cold because they receive extremely Then question number 3, how many heat or climatic zone is the earth divided into? Okay, so the earth is divided into how many heat and cold zones? So the earth is divided into 3 climatic zones, the torrid zone, the temperate zone and the frigid zone. Yes, why are the lines of longitudes called meridians of longitudes and lines of latitudes called parallels of latitudes? Okay, so the question is, so longitudes are semicircle of equal length. Okay, they are the semicircle of equal length. So that's why, hence, they are called the meridians of longitudes, whereas latitudes are parallel lines to the equator. Okay, they are parallel to the equator. That's why they are called the parallels of latitudes. Now, question number 5. Why is the world divided into time zone? Okay, so a system of time zone has been adopted. It was adopted since 1884 to avoid the confusion. Okay, to avoid the confusion of frequent changes of time when moving from one place to another. By international agreement, the world is divided into 24 time zones. Okay, our world is divided into 24 time zones or belt, and each time zone covers 15° of longitude. Okay, so let's proceed to the question answers in detail. Long question and answers. Name the various heat zones on the earth. Write one line about each of them. Okay, so the heat zones are torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. So about torrid zone, it lies between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. this zone receives maximum heat of the sun. Yes, if they receive maximum heat of the sun. Then comes the temperate zone. It lies between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. Sun rays. Circle and North Pole. They lies between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole. Okay, and Antarctic Circle and South Pole. It is the region of extreme cold because sun rays falls. Okay, it is the region in which extreme cold temperature is there, and that because of the sun rays falls absolutely slantingly over the region. Okay, so next question number 2. Why are the values of latitudes marked with an north or south, an or s, and those of longitudes with east or west, that is E or W? Okay, why do we mark them like this? So latitudes are parallel lines. All the latitudes are the parallel above the equator are marked as north. Okay, those who are above the equator, they are marked as north, and those who are below the equator, they are marked as south or s. Okay, and the longitudes are meridians. They are the meridians, and all the meridians to the east, the meridians which are to the towards the east, okay, of the prime meridian, they are marked as the E, that is east, indicating east, and to the west are marked as the W, indicating west. Okay, now let's proceed to question number 3. What is the time zone given example? So a system of time zone has been adopted since 1884 to avert the confusion of frequent changes of time when moving from one place to another. The local time within a time zone is defined as its difference. Okay, the local time, they define the difference between difference from coordinated universal time or the GMT. So UTC, that is coordinated universal time, changes 1 hour forward, okay, and backward, corresponding to a 1 hour difference in mean solar time for every 50 longitude in Greenwich, London, in United Kingdom. Okay, so question number 4. What is IST? IST stands for Indian Standard Time. It is the time at the Indian Standard Meridian, okay, which is followed in the whole country, okay, to avoid time confusion. It is followed in the whole country. The time that which we see in our watches and clocks, that is according to the Indian Standard Time, and it is followed in the whole country to avoid time confusion within the country, okay. The 82 degree 30 minutes east longitude, which runs almost through the center of the country near Allahabad, now called Prayagraj, okay, is therefore taken as the standard meridian. Okay, it is taken as the standard meridian for the whole country. Okay, it is the midpoint of the standard meridian, and according to that midpoint, the whole country's time is known. It is about 5 hours and 30 minutes ahead of UTC. Okay, it is ahead of the UTC, that is 5 hours ahead. Okay, now question number 5. What is the international dateline? Explain how time and date changes as a person crosses the IDL. Okay, so the by international agreement, the 180 degree meridian is called the international straight line. IDL means international date line. So its degree is 180 degree, and it is 180 degree both east and west, okay, on both east side and western side. And if we move from the right western hemisphere to the left eastern hemisphere of the 180 degree line, we get a the left. अगर हम left से जाएंगे to the right, left means from eastern hemisphere to the right western hemisphere तक जाएंगे, so we will go back by a day. वहाँ पर हम day, we will go back by a day or gain a day. या फिर हम back जाएंगे या फिर हम gain करेंगे. Okay, so that's all for the question and answers. So do your question and answers in your copy on time and learn them on time. Okay. Thank you, students. Take care. Don't go out.